In this video, I want to share with you why I decided to change which plasma center I donate at. And I found that there are actually some really good reasons why you should be selective with the plasma center that you choose. And so before I get going on that, I thought I would give you an update on my bandage ball. This is a ball of all the bandages, not all, probably within the last several months worth of donations. This is how many bandages I've got out of it. I just think it's kind of fun to have a visual representation of how many times I've donated plasma. But with that out of the way, let's explain why you should maybe change the plasma center that you're currently going to. I started donating plasma as a freshman in college because that's what you do when you're poor and they pay you pretty well for not very much of your time. If you're okay with the needles and kind of the uncomfortable feeling that can come with donating plasma, I have videos that describe some of how that feels and how that process feels. But if you're okay with that, it is pretty good money. So I started at Grifols Biomat is what it's called, and Grifols actually pays pretty well. So it starts at the normal donation compensation is $25 for your first donation of the month, and then every consecutive donation after that within a month goes up by $5. So your first donation is 25, second 30, 35, 40, all the way up to maybe 65 or 70, depending on how many donations you can get in that month, based on how many days in the month and what week or days of the week you're donating. So that's pretty good. You can make, I think the number is, if there's 9 donations, the last donation is 65, so I think that's 405 in a month. You might want to check my math. This is just off my memory. But then if there's 10 possible donations that month, you can get 475. Now, I decided to change and switch to Biolife for a couple of reasons. So the first thing that caught my eye was that Biolife was doing a new donor promotion where you could make $1,000 from your first 8 donations. That's huge. That's actually more than you would make being a COVID antibody donor. I don't know how those programs are going at this point. I don't know if they're those are discontinued, but at least at my local center at Grifols Biomat, they were paying people with COVID antibodies $100 per donation, which is great, but that's still $1,000 in 10 donations. This new donor promotion at Biolife was paying donors $1,000 for the first 8 donations. So that's crazy good. And so I switched over there for that reason, but I think I'm going to stay for a couple other reasons. They do different things with their pay. They kind of take it by a weekly basis, at least the way it is right now. I think without promotions, their pay is actually less per month than you can get at Grifols. That being said, I think they do a lot more promotions and incentives and bonuses than Grifols does. So for normal donors that are continuing at Biolife, they have this program where if you're going twice a week, your pay gradually increases until you're in the Platinum program. So I think if you're not in the Platinum program, your first donation of the week, you'll make $30, second donation $50, and that's like bronze or something. I don't know. That's about how I remember. But I think if you're in the Platinum program, so you've donated consecutively enough times that you've just bumped your way up on the pay scale, which I think you can do in just a few short weeks. It's really not hard. You'd get $30 the first donation of the week and then $90. So in theory, you'd be making $120 a week and, you know, about 4 weeks in a month. That's $480 a month. So that's a little better than Grifols, but that's a promotion. That's not necessarily, that Platinum program isn't necessarily always happening. So now that we have kind of the base pay out of the way and you understand what you're looking at with those two things, I didn't realize that there were different elements of the donation process and these different plasma centers that could be more favorable than others. So for instance, Grifols Biomat, the donation center that I've gone to many, many times, hundreds of times, is in a college town. And so it's super competitive. It's always slammed, so busy, really hard to schedule an appointment. Scheduling the appointment's done online, the website's not very user-friendly, so that's kind of annoying. Biolife has an app, and so I downloaded the app. That was cool. The app keeps you up to date on promotions and incentives that are going on. It's really easy to schedule. It's not as competitive. I do have to commute a little ways. It's about 20 minutes away, this Biolife Plasma Center is. But it's worth it because that's far enough away from the college town that it's not slammed with a bunch of college students. It does get busy still. A lot of people do it, and I have had to wait for probably 45 minutes still. But here's the other great thing. The donation process is actually faster at Biolife. And this is based off of these two centers, okay? I'm talking about the Grifols Biomat near me and the Biolife near me. But the reason it's faster is that their plasma machines, I don't think that's what you call them, I don't know what they're called, but at least at Grifols Biomat, the way it works, they take the blood out, it goes through a centrifuge that separates the plasma from the blood, and then they return the red blood cells, and there's several cycles that that you go through to make that happen. But at Biolife, their machine, instead of centrifuging it, I think it's called a selectively permeable membrane type filter system that is a lot quicker at separating the blood and the plasma, because the machines can only draw the blood out so fast. I mean, we don't wanna, you know, hurt people, or I mean, I'm sure there's reasons that you can only take so much blood so quickly from people. So that speed stays constant. However, the actual separating of the blood and plasma is much quicker at Biolife with their machines, with those membranes. And so you can actually get done substantially quicker. So I'm sitting here editing the video, and I'm realizing that the picture I chose as my background is actually a Grifols Biomat Center that has the machines that use the membrane filters. So I think it really just depends on where you're at. I didn't want to make it sound like only Biolife has these plasmapheresis machines, I think is the proper term, that separate the plasma from the blood quicker. So just so that we're clear, not trying to talk bad about Grifols. It's just good to be informed on what your local plasma centers offer, because those faster machines are a lot more convenient. At Grifols Biomat, it took me about 50 to 55 minutes to donate. And again, I take the longest to donate just because I am in the highest weight group, and so I donate the most plasma. It took about 50 to 55 minutes, so almost an hour hooked up to the machine. And I think the fastest time that I've done at Biolife has been 38 minutes, which is awesome. It feels like I'm not there for as long. My arm's not as sore as a result. And I really, really like that about Biolife. So those are the main reasons that I decided to switch my plasma centers recently. And so I would just strongly encourage all of you to shop around, see what bonuses are being offered. Some of these new donor incentives are crazy. So be on the lookout for those. But also in general, I mean, if your plasma center has those machines that use the membranes, for lack of a better word, rather than the centrifuges, that's gonna save you time, which saves you money in the long run, right? So something good to consider. And if you enjoyed this video, if you found it helpful, please subscribe. I have other videos on my channel already that talk about the plasma donation process, how you can make the most out of it. I'm actually planning on releasing a video in the near future that'll tell you exactly how you can maximize the amount of money you're making from plasma every month, because I've learned some new things as I've gone through it myself. And so if you're interested in that, please subscribe. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.